Shem Kevol Ma'uto Le'olam Vayet. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our Yah, the Lord is one. Blessed be the name of his glorious kingdom forever and ever. All praises to the Most High Yah. on the sixth day. We get up this morning seeking him first, the kingdom of the Most High Yah, and all his righteousness, knowing that all things shall be added unto us, because we come seeking, knocking, and asking. Because he is King of Kings and Most High Yahs of Most High Yahs. Aren't you excited to know that you are in a kingdom with kingdom principles for kingdom living? Aren't you excited that your lifestyle has changed? Because salvation is a lifestyle. It's how do I live my life? Aren't you excited that the Most High Yah chose you? Because many are called, but few are chosen. Aren't you glad that the Most High said, I can choose you because you were many in number or great in number. I chose you because you were few. There's only a few that can build the wall like in Nehemiah's time. There's only a few that will walk by faith and not by sight. There's only a few that will be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the word of the Most High Yah. There's only a few that will be obedient to the Most High Yah, when we know that obedience is better than sacrifice. Yeah. There's only a few that will say, speak, Yah, your servant is listening, because their ear is yield to hear the next instruction from the Most High Yah. There's only a few that don't operate out of themselves, but they humble themselves, because the word says, if I humble myself, then the Most High Yah would lift me up. You better know that there's only a few. There's only a few. I don't know why sometimes we think that when folks get off and stuff and, you know, and doing all kind of crazy stuff, there's only a few that don't have their own agenda. See, your agenda is the Most High's agenda. You know, even Yahushua says, I do as my father does. See, I don't do anything outside of what my father does. Come on now. Every word that I speak, it's from the Most High Yah. And I know it. Every word that comes out of my mouth on 5 a.m. prayer is from the Most High Yah. Sometimes we may not understand, but it's not about our understanding, because the word says to lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge the Most High Yah, because he is directing your path. In all your ways, acknowledge the Most High Yah. I don't think they say you directing your path, because he is directing your path. He's the director of your story. Come on now. He's the author and finisher of your faith. Yes. That's who he is. He's the Aleph. He's the first and the last. He knows the end from the beginning and the beginning from the end. So I thought about on yesterday, that prophetic word that came on yesterday, whether you were here on live or you went and listened to the replay or the playback, that was a prophetic word. Yeah. That word was to be still and know that he is the Most High Yah, right? Mm-hmm. Like we get on yesterday, like we always get on, and we get on with the agenda of the Most High Yah, and that's to teach the kingdom, right? Mm-hmm. So yesterday I had my plan. Mm-hmm. I had my plan to teach the kingdom of the Most High Yah, but the Holy Spirit came and fell on 5 a.m. prayer on yesterday and just ministered to us for about a good 20, 25 minutes, if that. Ministered to us about be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. How many of y'all listen to the teaching from yesterday, or was here on yesterday when the Most High Yah just gave us a be still word, and the word was still? How many of you that's on here this morning listened to it on yesterday? So after the The Most High Yah spoke so prophetically and said, be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. And that, you know, sometimes you feel like you want to faint, or you feel like, you know, the broken pieces, and you feel like you're falling apart. And the Most High Yah is like, no, you're not going to break apart. You may bend, but you won't break. You may bend, but you won't break, right? So, you know, after that word he gave so prophetically, I was like, okay, we not going to go on to the teaching. He was like, nope, that's what I got for you today. Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. Come on now. This battle is not yours. It's the Most High Yah. Stand still and see the salvation of the Most High Yah. Now, I did that at 5 o'clock in the morning, right? Well, at 10 a.m. on yesterday, at 10 a.m. on yesterday, my son that lives in Arizona, he had been sick already for 7 days, running a fever, 102, 101, 99, 100. I mean, he has been running his fever for like 7 days, right? So I said to him, Trey, you need to go and be retested, because he had went and got tested for COVID and it came back negative. But then after he got tested, all these symptoms came down, and I said, no, you got tested too early. And so I need you to go get tested for COVID. So who would have known after that be still message? Now, imagine I told him to go get tested for COVID a week ago. You know what I'm saying? This had been a week ago when I told him. And so yesterday at 10 a.m., he calls me, or rather texts me, and says, the test came back and it's positive. At that moment, you don't even know. At that moment, I begin to fall apart. You know that that's my son. At that moment, I begin to fall apart. The tears begin to fall. I begin to call people and you know, people that could pray and let them know that, you know, my son had tested positive for COVID. And then all of a sudden, that word from 5 a.m. prayer that morning began to drop in my spirit. And all the Most High Yah said was, be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. I'm like, okay, Most High, be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. Did you not put the blood on the doorposts on Passover? Did I not say that the death angel will pass over your house? So this sickness is not unto death, Dr. J. You better not start falling apart. I already gave you a word at 5 a.m. because I go before you and make the crooked places straight. I already gave you a word. I told you to clear out all distractions. Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. Now, who would have known right after that phone call at 10 a.m., my sister calls me at 11 a.m. and says, I think we all have COVID. My husband and my son, which are my nephews. I'm like, okay, Most High Yah. Okay, Most High. Now, Trey got COVID, and now my sister's, her whole family is walking in COVID. And the Most High Yah said, be still. Y'all don't even know. Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. Like, sitting here right now, and I'm thinking like I just want to break apart and, you know, break down and start crying. But he put a stillness on the inside of me, because he gave me an anchor for my soul. And that anchor grips the solid rock. And that rock is Yahushua. So I don't care what's going on in this pandemic. Be still and know that he is the Most High Yah. Oh, he watches over his word to perform it. He said, come on, Dr. J, you're walking in kingdom principles for kingdom living. I watch over my word to perform it. And I am a healer. You better just start sending Raphael and be still and know. You better start sending Raphael and be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. That's what you need to do. Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. So let me tell you one thing. When you begin to walk in kingdom principles for kingdom living, you will truly get an understanding of who the Most High Yah is. Walking in his teachings and instructions, walking in his commandments, knowing right now that he is the one and only Yah. Oh, I see we got a new person on here this morning. Okay. What you need to do is there is a button on your phone called volume. Just turn it down a little bit because the word says the fervent, effectual prayers of a righteous man availeth much. So I'm sorry if I might be a little too loud for you. So it might not be for you, but bless you, and thank you for whoever invited you to come on. They should have told you that it gets a little hot up in here because it's fire that the Most High Yah rains down from his throne. So don't want to offend you since the shouting is throwing you off. This might not be for you, but bless you, bless you, bless you, bless you, and bless you. But there is a button on the phone called volume. You can just turn me down a little bit so you can get a word from the Most High Yah. Because sometimes you might, you know, miss the Most High Yah because you're listening to the volume instead of the word. Okay. So I'm just excited about what the Most High Yah is doing in this time, in this season. So don't panic in a pandemic. Don't panic at all. Don't you be anxious for nothing. But in all things in prayer and supplication, making your petitions known before the King of Kings and Most High of Most High. You see, the Most High Yah is saying, I told you to clear out all distractions, because distractions will come. And if you're not careful, that distracting thing will throw you off and you won't be able to hear from the Most High Yah. So the most important thing is hearing from the Most High Yah. And we have to be careful because the enemy comes in real subtle. He comes in real subtle. You know, he would want you in your flesh to get offended. He comes in real subtle. So we have to be careful not to ever lean to our own understanding, because you already know, you already know, you already know. Not to lean to our own understanding, but in all our ways, we acknowledge the Most High Yah, because he is, not man, he is directing our path. So we have to always be anchored in the word. We always have to be steadfast in the word. Because if not, you might start operating in yourself instead of the Most High Yah. And I have said this million times before, and the Holy Spirit is telling me you got to release this. You really do. You know, I used to get real offended. I'm serious. When people would come on that had never been on 5 a.m. prayer, they'd be like, oh, Lord, she too loud. Why is she screaming? Why is she screaming? And, you know, I pray to the Most High Yah, because I've been doing 5 a.m. prayer for 13 years. And even in my prayer closet on a conference call, you know, some of the folks would be, oh, Lord, she just too loud. And so, you know, I would go to the Most High Yah and say, can you just turn me down just a little bit? He said, what did you say? Can you just turn me down just a little bit? And so he took me to the scripture that said, the effectual, fervent prayers of a righteous man availeth much. That's who you are, Dr. J. So I had to look up the word, fervent. The definition of fervent is hot, passionate, heated. So he said, the next time you ask me to turn you down, I'm going to turn you up even more. So I said, okay, I guess I'm the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man that availeth much. Passionate, hot, heated. So that's who I am. So let me give myself a little introduction. Maybe I need to introduce myself every time I come on 5 a.m. prayer. So I would kindly say to people, hey, I'm a little loud. And if I get too loud for you, there's a volume button on your phone. Turn it down. Thank you, Most High God. I love him because I used to walk in offense. That would cause me to have a heart condition like, nobody want to hear me because I'm too loud. He said, well, they ain't made for you. You might want to try me on first. They ain't made for you. So I'm thanking the Most High Yah that y'all continue to invite folks. But let folks know when you invite them that I'm passionate about what I do. Because guess what? If any of you have a sports team, and I love the Pittsburgh Steelers. If any of y'all have a sports team, or if any of your kids play sports, when they begin to run down the field, I don't think you at that football game saying, go, 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 go. I think you yelling, go, go, go. So you can yell for a sports team. Uh-oh. But you can't turn it up for the Most High Yah. You in the wrong place with the wrong mindset, so you might want to get off.
Come on now. Yes.
I'm just saying. Keep it real, Most High Yah. Keep it real. So when y'all be inviting folks to come on 5 a.m. prayer, let them know. If you don't like somebody loud, don't come on. You ain't going to put up in no comments talking about, the shouting is throwing me off. Bye. Woo! Hallelujah. He made me just the way I am. And I tried to change myself, child. I tried to change myself. I told him to turn me down. And he said, ask me to turn you down again. Please ask me to turn you down. Come to your prayer closet and say, Most High Yah, turn me down. And I'm going to turn you up. You're going to get louder. So I'm like, thank you, Most High Yah. So let's walk in the word. You know, sometimes you will miss the message. Because you're looking at the messenger. What you say, Most High Yah? Sometimes you will miss the message that the Most High Yah has for you. Because you're too busy looking at the messenger.
Come on now.
You came on here for a message, for a word from the Most High Yah. Don't miss the word because you're looking at the messenger. Okay, Most High, can we stop now? Because you know this ain't none of me. I don't mean like, okay, I'm good. Thank you for, you know, if y'all be for me, then who can be against me? This is all y'all speaking. This ain't Dr. J talking. I'm saying the Most High Yah. I'm trying to hold him back just a little bit. He said, oh, no, you ain't going to change what I made. She made in my image, in my likeness, and I called her to be fire.
Amen.
Straight fire. Mm-hmm. So thank you, Most High, for how you made me. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you. Woo! All right. So my son tested positive for COVID. And I'm telling you, that stillness, that, ooh, Crystal Queen, you were here on yesterday. Were you here yesterday or was the day before? Crystal Queen, after, you know, the Most High gave that prophetic message of be still and know that I am the Most High, y'all, like the stillness that he gave us on yesterday. And that was at 5 a.m., Queen Crystal. At 10 a.m., my son called me, and he was tested. He tested positive for COVID. And at that moment, I just started falling apart. This my son. This my baby, right? I just started, like, falling apart, crying. And all of a sudden, the Most High Yah said, already gave you a word. I already gave you a word. Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. Yes, Queen Crystal, you was here because I remember you putting in the comments, you said, confirmation. Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. Mm-hmm. Now, who would have thought after I got the 10 a.m. call that my son that lives in Arizona, that I can't get to him because I'm in Colorado, and he's 25 years old, be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. When he called me and said he had COVID, I was just like, you know, because, you know, I watch the news too much. And the Most High Yah set it up on yesterday. You on CNN, NBC, Channel 9 News now. You got all these distractions. And the first thing the enemy wants to do is take out your communication. Mm. And then I get that phone call that my son tested positive for COVID. And so right after that phone call, my baby sister calls and is like, I believe we all have COVID. You know, my nephews are sick, her husband is sick, she's sick. And so all I could see was, come on in here, Pastor Davis. I've been praying for you, King. Come on in here, Pastor Davis. And so when my sister called and said her entire house had COVID too, that message from yesterday morning at 5 a.m. is what's bringing me through, y'all. You cannot tell me that the Most High Yah is not prophetic on 5 a.m. prayer. That message is holding me together. Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. Be still. I don't know what your situation is. I don't know what you could be going through during this pandemic. I don't know if you lost your job. I don't know if you at home remote with your children. I don't know what kind of shifts in your has happened in your life in this very moment. Are you being attacked financially, spiritually, emotionally, financially, whatever it is, you better be still and know that he is the Most High Yah. We live in a kingdom. We might be in this world, but we're not of this world. We have kingdom principles for kingdom living, and we need to take the word of the Most High Yah. You have to get an instruction from him. And the instruction that he gave us on yesterday that's carrying us into today is be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. Now, apply that to whatever your thing is. Whatever's going on in your life right now, apply that instruction. Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. He creates the situation for revelation. You better come on, Pastor Davis. He creates the situation for revelation. Oh, I like that. I like that. Now, don't do that. I'm be done post that and stole it from you. Don't be mad now. I'm going to take that and post it. Love you, Pastor Davis. That is good. He's revealing that he is. Ooh, Yahushua Rapha. Woo! Go, Pastor Davis. You're going to teach this morning, then. Come on in here, Queen Robbie. I mean, can you believe that? Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. Ooh, I got an anchor for my soul. I got an anchor for my soul. I got an anchor for my soul. Mm-hmm. I got an anchor for my soul. I'm just going to be still. Y'all, come on now. And it's no time to move right now. See, the enemy was wanting to throw you off right now and have you fainting, have you doing all kind of crazy stuff. But you got to stand on that word. Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. Woo! So I got some prayer warriors on the wall this morning. My son's name is Trey. And when y'all send up prayers, please pray for my son. Pray for my son. And my family, the one that has COVID, they're the Griffith family. when you're praying in your prayers, because I got some prayer warriors on the wall. When you walk in Torah, you already know. You got folks, when they walking in Torah, you can ask them to pray for you. Now, if you're not walking in the Torah yet, don't pray for my son. Don't do it. Because your prayers are an abomination to the Most High God. We just going to keep it 100 this morning. And we're going to be 100. We're going to be 100 straight across the board. Okay? If you're not walking in the Torah yet, now don't be offended if you're not walking in the Torah. You still in the church. You just trying to have an ear to hear. You just came on for some information. I get it. You know, folks are there. They ain't crossed over yet. They ain't Hebrew. So if you're not walking in the Torah completely, do not pray for my son. So whether you're live or you're going to do the replay, because your prayers are an abomination, according to Proverbs. All right. Thank you for praying for my son. Come on. Fight. Fight. Mm-hmm. And it's crazy because my mom wasn't on live yesterday, and we were discussing this same thing. Stop it, Queen Crystal. Stop it. Wow. Go on, Pastor Davis. We pray. We will pray for Trey on the prayer line at 6:30. Thank you. Woo! One can chase 1,000, Pastor Davis, but two can put 10,000 to flight. And I know we got more than two on here praying for Trey, my son, and my sister's family, the Griffith family. Thank y'all for y'all prayers. Thank you so much. And thank you for being, you know, walking with the Most High Yah. You ain't walking with Dr. J. Child, don't look at me. Child, no, I can't do nothing without him. Thank you for walking with the Most High Yah. You know the spirit. Some folks trying the spirit by the spirit, and that ain't what it said. Mm. Try the spirit by the word of the Most High Yah. Uh-huh, yeah. Thank you, Most High Yah. Thank you. Thank you. We got some prayer warriors on here this morning. All right, let's go into this teaching. Kingdom principles for kingdom living. We are law-abiding citizens, which means we are legal in the earth realm because we're made in the image and likeness of the Most High Yah, and he has given us dominion. So when you speak words out of your mouth, because you are kings and queens, you create laws. So be careful of the words that you speak, because the power of life and death is truly in your tongue. And because you get the understanding that you are queens and kings, walk in your Yah-given authority and begin to decree a thing. Ooh, that's that authority. That's that authority. That's that authority. Decree a thing. We don't name and claim things as kings and queens. That's a religious mindset. Naming and claiming. We ain't naming and claiming nothing. We are kings and queens, and we are called to decree a thing. Mm-hmm. Through all you're getting, get an understanding. Now come on in here and walk in this kingdom. Woo, Most High. I come lifting up everyone on Facebook Live this morning. The ones that are listening live and the ones that will listen later. Thank you for the word that you have written on our hearts and on our minds. Your commandments, your teachings and instructions, your Torah. I lift up my son, Trey, to you this morning. You knew him before you formed him in my womb. You know the plans that you have for Trey. I ask Raphael right now, and I dispatch legions of messengers to encamp around his bed for complete healing. I ask you right now, you know, when the Satyrian man, that his daughter or a servant had fallen ill, and he came to Yahushua. And he said, when Yahushua asked, do you need me to come to your house? He said, no, send the word. So I send the word of healing all the way to Delaware, to my sister's house, to touch everyone in the house from the top of their heads to the soles of their feet, and that they would recover from this COVID-19. I send the word to Arizona that you would touch Trey from the top of his head to the bottom of his feet, and that he will recover from COVID. I thank you that we put the blood on the doorposts on Passover, and that the death angel is passing over all of our homes. I thank you that you teach us your word, your teachings and your instructions, kingdom principles for kingdom living. So have your way in our lives. We say, nevertheless, not our will, but thy will be done. Thou kingdom come, thou will be done. Giving you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And it's in the mighty, mighty name of Yahushua, I pray. All praises to the Most High Yah. The word says, if two or three gather together in his name, that he would be in the midst. The word says, if two touch and agree on anything, it shall be done. And I know I can't do nothing this morning without this word being established through the law, the prophets, in the writings. So the method style of study, it is a process of studying the word of Ahaya, Asha, Ahaya, which is I am, that I am in Hebrew, the great I am, the Yah of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And we seek his guidance and live in a kingdom lifestyle. The Torah is the Most High Yah's teachings and instructions in 613 principles. Is where the Creator speaks, Mother. And then we search the witnesses in the books of the prophets, the Nevi'ims, and the books of the writings, the Ketuvims. Collectively, the Torah, the Nevi'ims, and the Ketuvims, or identify as the Tanakh, which is the Old Testament's proper title. And it's the only book that Yahushua studied and referenced throughout the New Testament. Micah chapter 5, verse 2. But thou, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though thou be little, what? Among the thousands of Judah, yet out of thee shall he come forth unto me that is to be ruler in Israel, whose going forth have been from of old, from everlasting. Today we look to the word ruler. Hebrews number 4:9-10, marshal, to exercise dominion, to cause to rule. Y'all better be decreeing some things, kings and queens, and exercising dominion, calls to rule. The Torah testifies. Genesis chapter 45, verse 8. So now it was not you that sent me hither, but Yah. And he has made me a father to Pharaoh, and Lord of all his house, and a ruler throughout all the land of Egypt. The prophets proclaim, Isaiah chapter 28, verse 14, wherefore hear the word of the Most High, ye scornful men that rule this people, which is in Jerusalem. The writings bear witness. Judges chapter 8, verse 23, and Gideon said unto them, I will not rule over you, neither shall my son rule over you. The Most High shall rule over you. We have completed the method style of study this morning, reviewing ruler. First, we recognize there is a standard set in the Torah in 613 principles. Then we search the witnesses in the books of the prophets, the Nevi'ims, and the books of the writings, the Ketuvims. Collectively, the Torah, the Nevi'ims, and the Ketuvims, or identify as the Tanakh, which is the Old Testament's proper title. And it's the only book that Yahushua studied in reference throughout the New Testament. 5 a.m. prayer. The Most High Yah is in the process of bringing our mindset back to the original kingdom. Back to the original kingdom thought, which is the understanding that we are co-rulers with him. What you say? 5 a.m. prayer. The Most High Yah is in the process of bringing our mindset back to the original kingdom thought, which is the understanding that we are co-rulers with him. Zechariah chapter 6, verse 13. Even he shall build the temple of the Most High, and he shall bear the glory, and shall sit and rule upon his throne, and he shall be a priest upon his throne, and the council of peace shall be between them both. Shalom Aleichem. Peace be unto you, 5 a.m. prayer community. The Most High Yah is King of kings and Lord of lords. There is no one above him, and it's time we rule and reign with him in the midst of this modern day Babylon. Ooh, rise up, Judah, rise up. So now, are you ready for the word of Yah? Come on and read this constitution, Dr. J, and be still and know that I am Yah. I am the Allah. I'm the first and the last. I'm the beginning and the end. Are you ready for the word of Yah, the father of Abraham, the father of Isaac, the father of Jacob? This morning we are coming out of the book of Exodus. Exodus chapter 20. Is that King Reynard up in here? Exodus chapter 20 in its entirety. Bless you, King Reynard. Bless you, King. Exodus chapter 20 in its entirety, and it reads, and Yah spake all these words, saying, I am the Most High, thou Yah, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. This thing reading different for me today. I don't know about nobody else, but Exodus chapter 20 is reading different from me today. Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. And Yah spake all these words, saying, I am the Most High. Ooh, thou Yah, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Oh, this is an introduction to who I am. I am that I am. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Most High, thou Yah, am a jealous Yah, visiting the iniquities of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generations of them that hate me, and showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. Thou shalt not take the name of the Most High, thou Yah, in vain. For the Most High will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Most High, thou Yah. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou nor thou son, nor thou daughter, thou manservant, nor thou maidservant, nor thou cattle, nor thou stranger that is within thou gates. For in 6 days the Most High Yah made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and rested the seventh day. Wherefore the Most High blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Honor thou father and thou mother, that thou days may be long upon the land which the Most High thou Yah giveth thee. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not bear false witness against thou neighbor. Thou shalt not covet thou neighbor's house. Thou shalt not covet thou neighbor's wife, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor anything that is thou neighbor. And all the people saw the thundering and the lightning and the noise of the shofar and the mountain smoking. And when they saw it, they removed and stood afar off. And they said unto Moshe, speak thou with us and we will hear, but let not Yah speak with us lest we die. And Moshe said unto the people, fear not, for Yah is come to prove you, and that his fear may be before your faces, and ye sin not. And the people stood afar off, and Moshe drew near unto the thick darkness where Yah was. And the Most High said unto Moshe, thus thou shalt say unto the children of Israel, ye have seen that I, the Most High, have talked with you from heaven. Ye shall not make with me God of silver, neither shall ye make ye unto you gods of gold. An altar of earth thou shalt make unto me, and shall sacrifice thereon thou burnt offerings, and thou peace offering, thou sheep and thou oxen. And all the places where I record my name, I will come unto thee, and I will bless thee. And if thou wilt make me an altar of stone, thou shalt not build it of hewn stone. For if thou lift up thou tude upon it, thou hast polluted it. Neither shalt thou go up by steps unto my altar, that thou nakedness be not discovered thereon. May the Most High Yah add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his most holy word. Most High Yah, you know, you just do all things well. You just do all things well. The saints get the kingdom. What you say? The saints get the kingdom. It would be perfectly understandable if Daniel was almost overwhelmed by what he saw in his vision. Come on now. Come on in here this morning. Because remember, the prophet spoke about the kingdom of the Most High Yah. And who were the prophets that we were talking about in this series? Isaiah, Jeremiah, in Daniel. So come on and catch up now. The saints get the kingdom. It would be perfectly understandable if Daniel was almost overwhelmed by what he saw in his vision. If I had seen what he saw, I know I would have been. I think most of us would. Indeed, Daniel was deeply affected by his vision, not just the sheer power and majesty of the images themselves, but also the mystery surrounding them. Daniel longed to know what they meant. I, Daniel, was troubled in spirit, and the visions that passed through my mind disturbed me. I approached one of those standing there and asked him the true meaning of this. So he told me and gave me the interpretation of these things. The four great beasts are the four kingdoms that will rise from the earth. But the saints of the Most High will receive the kingdom and will possess it forever. Yes, forever and ever. Daniel chapter 7, verse 15 through 18. Although the four beasts represented four human kingdoms that were to arise, that is not the most important point. Say that again. Although the four beasts represented four human kingdoms that were to arise, that is not the most important point. What's important is the promise in verse 18 that the saints, the children of the Most High Yah, will receive and possess his kingdom forever, infinitely longer than the tenure of worldly kingdoms, no matter how great and powerful they may appear. Daniel then wanted to know the meaning of the fourth and the most terrible beast, as well as the meaning behind the 10 horns on its head and the one horn with the eyes and a mouth that replaced 3 of the original 10. As I watched, this horn was waging war against the saints and defeating them until the Ancient of Days came and pronounced judgment in favor of the saints of the Most High. In the time came when they possessed the kingdom, he gave me this explanation. The fourth beast is the fourth kingdom that will appear on earth. It will be different from all the other kingdoms and will devour the whole earth, trampling it down and crushing it. The 10 horns are 10 kings who will come from this kingdom. After them, another king will arise different from the earlier ones. He will subdue 3 kings. He will speak against the Most High and oppress his saints and try to change the set times and the laws. The saints will be handed over to him for a time, times, and a half a time. But the court will sit and his power will be taken away and completely destroyed forever. Then the sovereignty, power, and greatness of the kingdoms under the whole heaven will be handed over to the saints, the people of the Most High. His kingdom will be an everlasting kingdom, and all rulers will worship and obey him. This is the end of the matter. I, Daniel, was deeply troubled by my thoughts, and my face turned pale, but I kept the matter to myself. Daniel chapter 7, verse 21 through 28. Man forfeits the kingdom. What you say? Man forfeits the kingdom. What did we, the human race, lose at the fall? Come on now. What did we, the human race, lose at the fall? Heaven? No. We did not come from heaven, nor were we created for heaven. I'm going to say that again, because some of y'all think y'all going to die and go to the by and by in the sky. Y'all got your mansion up there in heaven. Uh-oh. What did we lose in the fall? Heaven? No. We did not come from heaven, nor were we created for heaven. We were created from the dust of the earth to rule over the earth. You better say that again, Dr. J. We were created from the dust of the earth to rule over the earth. What we lost at the fall was not heaven, but the kingdom.
Come on.
What we lost at the fall was not heaven, but the kingdom. Yahushua would die on a crucifixion state and rose from the dead, not so much to take us to heaven as to bring us back into possession of the kingdom we lost. When we receive it, we possess it forever and ever. Say that again, Dr. J. When we receive it, we possess it forever and ever. Hasatan will fight against our restoration. And he lost in his loss of power with everything he got. That is the conflict that lies between the rise in activities of the fourth beast. This fourth kingdom probably represent both the Roman Empire as well as the future kingdom of the Antichrist. As before, however, the focus of this passage is not on the oppressive power and cruelty of this beast, but on his certain and complete destruction and the coming of the saints and to the eternal kingdom. These are the very saints whom the beast had persecuted and oppressed. Verse 27 mentions three specific things that the children of the Most High Yah will receive when they come into the kingdom. Sovereignty, power, and greatness. Y'all better come on now. I've come to give you an unshakable kingdom. Verse 27 mentions three specific things that the children of the Most High Yah will receive when they come into the kingdom. Sovereignty, power, and greatness. Sovereignty means absolute power. Y'all better come on out of religion into relationship. Y'all better get an understanding that it's about a king in the kingdom when you read the Bible. Sovereignty means absolute authority in a true monarchy. A king is sovereign because his word is law. What you say? A king is sovereign because his word is law. The Most High Yah is the only true sovereign because he is answerable to no one except himself. All other sovereignty is delegated sovereignty, which implies a delegator who is greater. Within the scope of our delegated sovereignty, we have absolute authority. This means that we do not have to sit by helplessly while the enemy wreaks havoc in our lives. What coronavirus? What you say? Be still and know that I am the Most High Yah. This means that we do not have to sit by helplessly while the enemy wreaks havoc in our lives. We can stand up to him. In the name of Yahushua, take authority over our situation. That is our right as kingdom citizens in good standing. Many times we bow under burdens we should not have to bear. Come on now. Many times we bow under burdens we should not have to bear. Yahushua bore our burdens on a crucifixion stake and bought our victory. Our problems is that we refuse to claim it. Our slave mentality blocks us off from so much that is ours for the asking. And we settle for the far-off dream of a pie in the sky, by and by. What you say? Our problem is that we refuse to claim it. Our slave mentality blocks us off from so much that is ours for the asking. And we settle for the far off dream. I'm going to heaven of the pie in the sky by and by. When Yahushua restored the kingdom to us. What you say, Holy Spirit? When Yahushua restored the kingdom to us, he did not give us a pretty faucet, a barricade with nothing inside. Along the kingdom, he gave us power, power to overcome, prosper, live in victory, be joyful, and to fulfill our potential. What you say? Along with the kingdom, he gave us power, power to overcome, prosper, live in victory, be joyful, and to fulfill our potential. Finally, with the kingdom comes greatness. Ooh, y'all better come on up in here today. Finally, with the kingdom comes greatness. Man was created in the Most High's image, the crowning glory of his creative activity, designed to rule over the earthly domain. What you say? I am a queen. What you say? Come on, kings and queens. The Most High Yah is telling you about your authority in the earth realm. Finally, with the kingdom comes greatness. All right now, man was created in the Most High Yah's image, the crowning glory of his activity, designed to rule over the earthly domain. As lost and fallen sinners, we still bear the Most High Yah's image, but only a faint shadow of our former glory. When we are restored to the kingdom, we are restored to greatness. All right now, when we are restored to the kingdom, we are restored to greatness, because we return to the place and environment from which we were created. What you say? Because we return to the place and environment for which we were created. Yahushua said that the key to true greatness is humility in service. Bless you. Bless you, Pastor Davis. Yahushua said that the key to true greatness is humility in service. Remember that in his vision, Daniel saw the kings serving the king. Mm. Remember that in his vision, Daniel saw the kings serving the king. Once again, Yahushua set the example when he, the King of Kings, took up a towel and bowed in a bowl of a servant and washed his feet. At another time, he told them, "For even the Son of Man did not come to serve, but to serve." Didn't come to be served, but to serve. And to give his life as a ransom for many. I think that's where we get off sometimes as ministers and pastors and prayer warriors and evangelists and prophets and apostles. is that we have to ransom ourselves for many. People not going to always appreciate. All you need to do is make this word available. That's it. He gave himself as a ransom for many. We were not created to dominate each other or to be dominated, but to serve one another equally as kings and priests in our Abba's kingdom. It is only when we understand our place and role in the kingdom that we can fully appreciate the meaning of greatness. So good, so good, so good, so good. Bring it back down. So good, so good, so good, so good. It is only when we understand our place and role in the kingdom that we can fully appreciate the meaning of greatness. Now, here are your chapter principles. The Most High Yah's scepter, the defining characteristic of his rule, is justice. We live in victory and walk in confidence because the power of our enemy has been broken. Yahushua died on a crucifixion stake and arose from the dead. Not so much to take us to heaven as to bring us back into possession of the kingdom we lost. As children of the Most High Yah, we receive three specific things when we come into the kingdom: sovereignty, power, and greatness. Within the scope of our delegated sovereignty, we have absolute authority. When we are restored to the kingdom, we are restored to greatness because we return to the place and environment for which we were created. All praises to the Most High Yah. All praises to the Most High Yah. We gonna do that tomorrow. So good, so good, so good, so good, so good. All praises to
now connected to Jesus iPhone.
Who so good, so good, so good, so good. Thou kingdom come, thou will be done on earth as it is in heaven. I give you an unshakable kingdom. I have given you the keys of the kingdom. Whatever you bound in the earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose in the earth shall be loosed in heaven.
Thank you.
teaching, this kingdom teaching, sets you on fire. I'm like Jeremiah. It's just like fire. Shut up in my bones. When you teach the kingdom, a fire gets started. Come on now. They call me fire starter. What you say? They call me fire starter. Like a firecracker. You better know right now. The fervent, effectual prayers of a righteous man availeth much. Pastor Davis, I honor you. I honor you. I honor you. Can you please, please, please put the number to your prayer line? Because we need a tour of prayer line. You understand me? Folks be getting on prayer lines. There ain't no prayer line. Y'all need to get on Pastor David's prayer line. So can you put your prayer line number up in the comments? And if y'all have never heard Pastor Davis teach, the brother is teaching. Okay? The king is teaching. So thank you. I honor you. I honor you. I honor you. Bless you. Pastor Davis, bless you. Child, this race ain't given to the swift, you better know, but to he that endures to the end. Bless you, King Reynard. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. Queen Adrian, girl, what? Queen Erica, Queen Evelyn. Who else? I saw King Ali up in here. Yes. Fire started, girl. Gonna come up in here and talk about, I can't hear for the shouting. Bye. Bye. Y'all better tell folks when they invited to 5 a.m. prayer. It is straight fire now. Don't come up in here talking about it's too loud. What? You don't know how to hear with that. But the Most High, y'all taught that kingdom message. He taught that. Look at Queen Crystal. I see you, girl. She's still here. She said, that Dr. J is crazy. She just done really told it like the T.I.E.L.S.
He said,
dude,
you got
it. Okay, Queen Crystal, I love you, girl, already. I'm like, Queen Crystal's like, girl, please, y'all better stop. Y'all better stop it. Do you, Dr. J? Oh, Pastor Davis, bless you. He said, this stirred my soul today. Blessings, Dr. J. I know you didn't say that. Emphasis added. I'm just thankful. I'm thankful for each and every one of you. I can't do 5 a.m. prayer without you. LOL. I love you too. Volume and all. All right now. That is too funny. Yes, I love y'all. I can't do this without y'all. I'm so glad we together. I am really glad we together because you know what? Y'all seeking y'all. Y'all seeking him. So seek him for the word. I might have to borrow a few things. Take them all. They ain't mine, Pastor Davis. You can take all that. And I got it all written up in the comments. Go with it. Go. Shoot. We together. We roll together. I love that King Reynard. Bold tongue. I love it. That's right. Look, I'm getting louder. But yeah, this kingdom teaching is off the chain. Now, what y'all don't want to miss is tomorrow. Tomorrow at noon, Mountain Standard Time, we're going to wrap up this understanding kingdom philosophy. I think my mind is blown from this series that we've been doing all Sabbath. Is this the fourth one? Uh-huh. It got four parts. Y'all going to be all right. We're going to do part four tomorrow, understanding kingdom philosophy. We're going to teach this kingdom message until the kingdom come. Because, you know, they thought they was going to heaven. You ain't going to no heaven. You are not going to heaven. Stop it. You're going to be right here ruling and reigning in the earth realm. All right. Woo. Mm-mm-mm. See, look at Pastor Davis. This is the unity we were teaching on last night. Yes, we together. You know, I'm going to took some of your stuff, Pastor Davis. As quiet as he kept, brother, I'm going to take some of your stuff. But I'm going to honor you for it, though. I'm going to be like, according to Pastor Davis, and I'm going to do your whole teaching. I just love it that we can just love on one another, for real. It's a kingdom mindset. It's a kingdom mindset. When you come out of religion, you ain't in no competition. You know, religion taught you to, you know, it's a competition. I gotta compete. I'm not competing against nobody. We are all teaching the word of the Most High Yah, and we need to support one another. It ain't easy. Jeanette, Dr. J did not want to come on no Facebook Live. The Most High Yah told me to come on here. I was like, no. I'm not going on no Facebook Live. They're going to have to see me. I used to do a conference call. 5 a.m. prayer has been going on for 13 years. I've been doing this for 13 years. And I was in my little prayer closet on a conference call, praying on a conference call. And then one day, they took the conference line down. And then the people on my team going to say, oh, well, they got Facebook Live. You're going to have to go live. I said, when? They said tomorrow. What? That mean they going to have to see me. You know, I will always keep me hidden, Most High. Keep me in the closet with the door shut. And look at Queen Gina. Gina said, I remember that call. Yes, girl. I wanted to stay in that closet. Mm-mm. And the Most High threw me out here on Facebook Live. I said, no, no, no. Well, obedience is better than sacrifice, Pastor Davis. If you on here teaching, it ain't because you want to, brother. Obedience is better than sacrifice. So just know that. Yeah, just know that. Obedience. Just do what y'all say. Don't worry about nobody. Just make it available. Now, you come over here dishonoring Dr. J. Now, you're going to get what you get and don't throw a fit. Like I tell my daycare kids, you're going to get what you get and don't throw a fit. Now, you ain't going to come on Facebook Live for 5 a.m. prayer and dishonor me. You going to get what you get and don't throw a fit. All right, that's it. I'm off my own soapbox. Thank you, Most High Yah. He defended me this morning. I was like, Most High, we good. I ain't got no problem. You know, they always said I was loud. I'm cool. He went off. I was like, if Yah be for me, then who can be against me? He called me great in the kingdom. I don't know about nobody else. Mm-hmm. He called me great in the kingdom. Because we're teaching his commandments, his teachings and instructions. Don't come for us if we don't send for you. You better shut your mouth and keep on talking, Pastor Davis. Don't come for us if we don't send for you. All right now. That's what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. Pastor Davis, you done blessed me this morning. You have really blessed my soul. Thank you. Sometimes, you know, we need to talk, brother. We need to talk. All right now. So let's go and close this thing out. Uh-huh. May the Most High Yah bless you and keep you. May the Most High Yah make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Most High Yah lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. We are about to go into some sweet Sabbath rest at sunset tonight. Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Enter into his rest. And please, 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 everyone, keep my son Trey lifted. I am still a mother. And I ain't going to say I don't want to say I'm scared because I'm not scared. I'm very concerned. Because my son has chronic asthma. So we don't need this COVID thing attacking his lungs. I need y'all to please pray for my son who was tested positive for COVID on yesterday. And pray for my sister and her family. They are experiencing symptoms of COVID because they little boys, my little nephews, they play football, and one of the little boys tested positive for COVID, and now their whole house is sick. So they took the test, and they're waiting on the results. But I hear the Most High right now in my spirit saying, whose report shall you believe, Dr. J? Whose report shall you believe? Be still and know that I am Yah. That's enough for me right there. That's enough for me right there. Fervent prayers going up this morning for your family. Yah is in control. You right. You right, Queen Crystal. Yah is in control. Come on, Queen Gina. Be still and know. That's it. By his stripes, they are healed. Bless you, Pastor Davis. All right. Tomorrow at noon, we start the praise and worship. You know, get you ready now. Y'all do that praise and worship thing now. We putting all them songs out. Y'all do the praise and worship. And then I'm going to come with this final teaching, part four of Understanding Kingdom Philosophy. Oh, Pastor Davis, those four parts were so awesome. It's recorded. 5 a.m. prayers on YouTube. If y'all want to get those four teachings on Understanding Kingdom Philosophy, it's amazing. Okay? I love y'all. So get to the blog spot. We got a blog spot. 5ampray.blogspot.com. We got a blog spot. So get to the blog spot. Get to Facebook. Get to YouTube. It will encourage you. Have a supernatural 6 day going into the 7th day. Enter into his rest. I love you, love you, love you. Oh, I love you. You know I love you. Bye now. So good. So good.